The U.S. Army just successfully tests its scramjet-powered hypersonic missile. According to recent Lockheed Martin and DARPA press releases, the United States successfully tested a scramjet-powered hypersonic missile last month. In-flight speeds of more than Mach 5, or around 3,838 miles per hour, are possible with hypersonic missiles, a new generation of highly developed weaponry. These missiles are nearly impossible to intercept with current missile defense technologies due to their speed and mobility. Is America really losing the hypersonic arms race, or everything is just kept a secret? Let's find out. Hey guys, and welcome to our channel Future Warplanes, where we tell you about military fighter jets, military drones, military planes from the currently famous in the air to the most advanced around the world. And in addition, for the latest episodes, we'll be covering all military defense news. So stay with us till the end of this video so you don't miss out on any of this information. And before we proceed, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos in the future. For the first time since the early Cold War, America is falling behind its international rivals in a race for technological advancement with significant military and diplomatic ramifications. One of six new technologies identified by the Pentagon as having the potential to determine how future wars are resolved is the use of hypersonic weapons. But as long as the United States rivals are developing hypersonic missiles, its own efforts will continue to fail. What gives then? How is it that the Russian military, which receives just $61 billion a year, already has two hypersonic weapons, while the United States, with a defense budget of over $700 billion, is unable to do the same? Well, the reality is complicated, as truths often are, and as you'll see in today's video, the mere question might not accurately capture the true nature of the hypersonic weapons race we are currently engaged in. And just recently, the United States seems to be the frontrunner in developing scramjet-powered hypersonic missiles, despite the fact that China and Russia already have hypersonic boost guide weapons in use. The Hypersonic Air-Breathing Weapon Concept, or HAWC, a high-speed weapon that uses cutting-edge new scramjet propulsion to achieve hypersonic velocities, was successfully tested by the Lockheed Martin variant. The Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, Air Force Research Lab, or AFRL, Lockheed Martin and Aerojet Rocketdyne collaborated to develop this weapon. According to a report published in January, Eric Sheriff, Vice President of Hypersonic Strike Programs at Lockheed Martin Space, hypersonic systems provide a combination of speed, maneuverability, and operating altitude that enables highly survivable, long-range capability for the rapid defeat of time-critical, heavily defended, and high-value targets. The HAWC missile initiative led by DARPA has already achieved two successes, but this is the first one to use a Lockheed Martin scramjet propulsion system. An HAWC missile made by Raytheon and propelled by the scramjet from Northrop Grumman had previously been tested successfully. No country has ever successfully fielded an operational system, weapon, or vehicle powered by scramjets, despite the fact that the technology has been studied for decades. According to Andrew Tippy Nadler, Program Manager for the Lockheed Martin HAWC and DARPA's Tactical Technology Office, this Lockheed Martin HAWC flight test successfully demonstrated a second design that will enable our warfighters to choose the appropriate capabilities to dominate the battlefield in a competitive manner. These accomplishments raise the technological maturity needed to convert HAWC into a service program of record. The HAWC may maneuver in midair to avoid being intercepted, just like conventional cruise missiles do. It follows a trajectory that is relatively stable, like that of an airplane. The missile, which was reportedly launched from a B-52 Stratofortress off the coast of the West Coast, was originally propelled by a conventional rocket booster before later being propelled by a Lockheed Martin scramjet once it reached a speed that allowed for the scramjet. No information on the HAWC's top speed or range is yet known. However, reports suggest that this recent test was carried out at moderate hypersonic speeds just above Mach 5 at an altitude greater than 65,000 feet for more than 300 miles. 300 miles would be covered in about 5 minutes at current speeds. With Russia, China, and the United States all scrambling to develop and field various types of high-speed weapons, hypersonic missiles have been the focus of what some have referred to as a modern-day arms race. Hypersonic boost glide vehicles and scramjet-powered cruise missiles are the two main types of contemporary hypersonic weapons. China and Russia both currently have hypersonic boost glide vehicles in use, but no country's yet to perfect scramjet technology to deploy a hypersonic cruise missile. David Berganini, Vice President of Hypersonic and Strike Systems at Lockheed Martin Missiles and Fire Control, told us in January that traveling at speeds of Mach 5 or faster produces extremely high levels of heat. As a result, new materials, sensors, and electronics are required to withstand such speeds throughout the journey. These systems must be able to maintain reliable communication connections as well as sufficient intelligence to perform precise maneuvering tactics to overcome a wide spectrum of advanced defense systems in extremely contested areas, according to the report. At least in the early phases of their flight path, hypersonic boost glide vehicles aren't all that unlike from the warheads on conventional long-range ballistic missiles. Similar to conventional ICBMs, they are propelled into the upper atmosphere by high-velocity boosters, though usually to a lower altitude. The missile then releases one or more glide vehicles, which use thrusters that may be maneuvered, or momentum, and control surfaces to manage their rapid drop as they approach their targets. These are the only hypersonic weapons that are currently in use by any country. Examples include the DFZF anti-ship weapon from China and the Avangard nuclear boost glide weapon from Russia. While the U.S. has pledged to only develop conventionally armed hypersonic missiles, both of these weapons are regarded as nuclear capabilities. Boost glide weapons are entirely different from hypersonic cruise missiles like the HAWC. Instead of gliding at great speeds from great altitudes, they use a sophisticated propulsion system known as a scramjet for powered flight. A scramjet, also known as a supersonic combusting ramjet, is a ramjet that uses supersonic airflow to ignite combustion. Due to the fact that scramjets are only effective at high speeds, these missiles are frequently launched from swiftly moving aircraft or employ an alternative kind of propulsion, such as the rocket booster, used in the most recent HAWC missile test to reach their desired speeds. In addition to numerous parallel initiatives in boost glide vehicles and scramjet-powered cruise missiles, the U.S. has approximately 70 hypersonic weapon systems in various stages of development. America's attempts have, however, been sluggish and fraught with failure. Over the course of the last 12 years, there have been 17 tests of hypersonic weapons in total, and 10 of those tests have failed entirely or partially. Although many scramjet attempts have failed, this hasn't always been the case. Instead, technical issues with unrelated support systems, including rocket boosters, have often been at blame. Despite having a reputation for being behind in hypersonic technology, the U.S. may really be the frontrunner when it comes to scramjet systems, according to the success of a second HAWC missile design. Scramjet technology has proven to be extremely difficult to develop in large part due to how difficult it is to maintain combustion while air is moving through the engine at Mach velocities. This difficulty has been compared to trying to keep a candle lit amid a cyclone in terms of its nature. And that's going to do it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed our video. If you did, please click on the like button and make sure you share with your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments for us, please make sure you share them with us in the comment space below. And also don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more incredible videos from us. And check out these other ones that have been specially selected for you. And we'll catch up in the next one. Thank you for watching.